my effing beautiful song, guys. That is one of those songs when you meet someone and you go, Led Zeppelin, they're a heavy metal band. And you go, bollocks, mate, listen to the Rain song. Just listen to the Rain song, you'll see how heavy metal is. Okay, so now we've had the very big musical drama, the epic. Now it's time to have a bit of fun. We done four already, and now we're steady, and then they went.
One, two, three.
Thank you.
That is a classic. That is one of those songs that seems easy to begin with. But if you don't quite know it, I just recently did Rock and Roll Fantasy Camp. And that was one of the most requested songs we did from all these different guys wanting to play and dance. And that caught a lot of drummers out. Especially when I was playing the one way and they were playing a different way. It sounded like 10 drummers falling down the stairs with their drums on their back. These screams behind are here for a reason tonight. Because when we put the show together, I always said, I can't just go up there and play some Led Zeppelin songs. I feel it needs to be more. So therefore, a personal touch. That's why I kind of tell the stories every now and again. But this one, I was looking for some footage of my father and my grandmother, God bless her soul. She said, oh, I've got some footage of your dad when he's a kid. And I'm like, I don't think they had cameras back then, Grandma. She's like, and she goes, don't be such a cheeky bastard. Because of course we had cameras. And I'm like, okay. So, and it wasn't only just, it was colour. And my dad was about 10 or 11 years old. And then even some stuff when he's just gone through that weird growth spurt and he was still wearing somebody else's clothes. We did that in England when you didn't have that much money. It was a hand-me-down thing. But he soon grew into them. You will see. Yeah, he filled them out. That's what they called it, Moby Dick. Don't worry. Yeah. Interesting fact. Before Moby Dick was called Moby Dick, does anybody know what the drum solo was called?
Moby Dick!
It was called Pat's Delight. My mum's name is Pat. What does that say? So, Joan Bonham, my grandmother, my dad's mum, was the woman responsible for taking him down to the jazz clubs, pushing him onto the band leader and saying, let my son play drums.
Yeah.
Which crafted the star that he had, which we know and love. So you've got to thank her. She is the woman. Yeah. He didn't have a drum kit at home. He just had a snare drum. He didn't get a drum kit until he was 16. And then when you think within 3 years he was doing what he was doing, it makes you go, really? Maybe I should take it to the top. Later on I found out it was really because she liked the trumpet player. And I ended up with an Uncle Jerry. Don't we all have an Uncle Jerry? Who was a very wonderful man, and God bless him too. He always encouraged my father. He said, listen, don't let the singer just stand up front. You set the drum kit up front. If someone's going to get noticed, so are you.
Yeah.
And then he was barred from every pub in England for being too loud. So, with this footage, you see the young boy that would grow up to be Bonzo, that would throw TV sets out of windows, and every mud shark and red snapper feared him. It's my way of saying thank you. To his parents when they were 16. Wow. Oh, some very special stuff. We so far so good, yeah.
Yeah.
get a little choked up sometimes. They have a wonderful acoustic side, Led Zeppelin. And also, as we go into that side of things, there is a B-side to a song that never made it onto an album until much, much after they split up. Anyone can guess what that song is? I'll give you a hint, it was the B-side of Immigrant Song. 1, 2, 3, 1.
This is a huge.
Well, we know that one. Okay, we can try that. Well then, hey Houston, let's have a go at this one.
Cosplay.